This is going to be a very quick video on how to make a starter for one of the hit and miss engines. A 5/16 bolt, piece of 1/4 inch plywood, preferably a good plywood like Baltic birch, and that's a 9/16 hole drilled in the center of it. And the head of that 5/16 bolt will just go in there. Mix up some epoxy, put this on a piece of plastic or something flat, put epoxy around the inside, put epoxy around that bolt head, and shove that down in there, and make sure that this is below the surface, and you want to square that. So that's square in both directions. Clean this up, make sure this is good and smooth, use a paper towel, a little alcohol, and let that set up overnight. The next day, sand this smooth and epoxy another piece of plywood on that flat, and a third piece with a 5/16 hole in it, push down over that, and you'll end up with a sandwich like this. This is a 4.5 inch disc. Make it a little bit big, find the center in it. Take this piece, chuck it up in a lathe, and turn this to a true outside diameter. You want this to spin true. Take your disc, draw a circle the same size as your sandwich disc with the bolt in it, and epoxy that dead center in that disc. This is a piece of MDF. You want a hole in here that's a little bit smaller than the outside of this flywheel. Very accurately glue that centered on this disc. When that is all set up, chuck this up in a lathe and turn this to an accurate outside diameter. Turn this inside diameter to where it just goes on that flywheel. It's a nice fit, but it's not tight. It just jiggles a little bit. This inside piece of rubber is cut from a flat, unused shoe insert. I use the flywheel to draw a circle around this to cut it out, and there has to be a little indentation in here to clear this piece of the crankshaft that's sticking out. Make sure this is turning counterclockwise, and to start the engine, you put this on here and you just push. You push a little bit in this direction. That rubber is just pushing against the rim of the flywheel. There's not a whole lot of compression here. They don't offer much resistance to starting. Once this engine has run a little bit, the O-ring piston rings have flattened out a little bit. It's gained a little bit of compression, and I can now start this by hand most of the time. Cut these threads off and clean up that edge. This will go into the drill chuck a lot easier.